Hi, this is Sheshanan. Welcome to Aerotech Solutions. We are giving microcontroller based applications with different peripheral interfaces. You can subscribe on YouTube from Aerotech Solutions as channel name, and also Facebook, you can like us. So let's see this application with 8051 microcontroller. So I try to implement visitor counter application using 7 segment displays with microcontroller. I'll show you the block diagram of this application. So this application contains different blocks as power supply and one entry sensor. Here I arranged infrared sensor unit to identify the persons, and so I designed one entry display with 2-digit multiple 7 segment. So the same action on exit also. The exit sensor, so one more infrared sensor I connected across microcontroller, and 2-digit multiple 7 segment display I used to display exit count. So power supply unit, which is used to convert AC to DC. Most of the electronic devices works on DC source. So this DC source required for different peripherals from the application. The DC source I'm converting by using this unit. And again, the different sections involved in this power supply unit as bridge rectifiers, filters and regulators. The working of each and every section is very clear. Rectifier converts to AC to DC, but it is not pure DC, it's a pulsating DC. To filter these ripples, you need to use filters, and you need to regulate your voltage for fixed and constant voltage by using regulators. Regulators allows to give constant output irrespective of any input. So this DC source I am using for all these individual modules. I will show you the circuit diagram of this application. So this application contains different blocks as shown on above diagram. Now coming to the circuit connections. So let's see this infrared module, which is available directly. It contains 3 pins, VCC, ground and output. So anyway, you have to give power supply connections across VCC and ground. The output line of this sensor and you need to give to microcontroller. The same thing I am doing for other unit, same. This is for entry and this is for exit. So now coming to this 7 segment display connections, I am taking 2-digit multiple 7 segment. So the 2-digit 7 segment, it contains common data lines for all individual segments and 2 common pins from this device. So the data lines I connected with one complete port from microcontroller, which is port 1, and exit display data lines connected across port 2. The 2 common pins of entry display connected across P3.2 and P3.3. The exit sensor exit display common pins are connected with P3.0 and 3.1. So these 2 output lines are connected across P3.4 and P3.5. So connections are clear. Common pins are connected 3.0, 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, and sensor outputs are connected across P3.4 and P3.5. When data lines of each segment, which is connected across port 1 and port 2, because you should be very clear on these hardware connections. So you need to declare all these hardware connections in source code. So that's why every time you need to check your hardware connections before writing program. Now I'll show you the source code of this application, which is already developed in Keil Microvision IDE. The Keil Microvision IDE supports for different microcontrollers programming. So this is a very popular IDE for all microcontroller programmers. And the steps you need to go through this Keil Microvision as create project and giving project name and choosing microcontroller from specific manufacturer. So all these steps you need to do before writing program. So and later you can open your editor window and start writing programs. So this is the program for your visitor counter application. So this is the first line of your program, which is hash include reg51.h. See, the hardware connections I am declaring here by using the standard data type, which is SBIT. SBIT stands for single bit from single bit for declaration. Any single bit you are trying to declare from SFR registers, you need to use this standard data type SBIT. So as per hardware connections, the two common pins of in exit display and two common pins of entry display connected across 3.0, 3.1. So if you have any confusion, you can prepare your comment lines. And these two for entry display common pins. So now these two are sensors I connected across P3.5 and P3.4. Now this is one user defined delay function which I am taking for calling delay between switching operation of 7 segments. Now main logic starts from here. I am taking 6 temporary variables as integer data type, and these are segment values calculated from lookup table. You have to prepare your own lookup table for common anode and common cathode devices. So these are standard hexadecimal values to operate your common anode 7 segment. As per your selection, you have to give these values. These are values equivalent of 0 to 9 for your 7 segment display. The initial declaration of ports is 00. Now I am entering into this infinite loop while of 1. Now if entry sensor is detected, then I am incrementing V1 variable value by 1. So if you are not giving this while, if you are not waiting here, the V1 which is keep on incrementing, because user will operate sensors with more time generally. So there is a delay between moving of person in front of sensors. So if you are not keeping this, your variable value which is keep on incrementing even for 1 sense. So that I am waiting here until the person who passed away from this entry sensor, then for next entry it is detected by 1 and variable value increments by 1. So I am waiting here until the person who passes away from this entry sensor. The same thing for exit sensor. So I am writing two if conditions in this logic. I am checking entry sensor logic and incrementing V1 value by 1 in this entry part. And coming to this exit part, I am incrementing V2 variable value by 1. The same thing I am applying here. I am waiting until the person passes away from this exit sensor. Now I need to convert these two variable values into two, I need to split into two digits, because I have to pass the values for two individual 7 segments. So anyway, variable value which increments by 1, but it is in hexadecimal format. So that I need to split into two digits. So I am following this quotient and remainder concept here and dividing with 10 and modulo with 10. The V1 value I am separating as two digits. So one for first segment and second digit for second segment. So you know that whenever you are dividing with 10, you will get quotient, and if you are finding modulo, you will get remainder. Suppose the count is 1. 1 divides with 10, quotient is 0 and remainder is 1. So that I am expecting 0, 1 as display from 7 segment. So that I am activating first common pin and giving proper value for your 7 segment, which is P1 is equal to segment of V4. And every time I'm switching my common pins, see here, the V3 value I'm finding as quotient and V4 which is saved with remainder. So these two digits I'm passing to this entry display with the help of this logic. And then I have to continue for exit display also. If the V2 value increments by 1, suppose if it is 00, the exit display allows 00 display. Okay, so suppose even exit is also incremented by 1, then V2 also split it into two digits as 0, 1. So the display I'm assigning with P2 here, because entry display data lines connected across port 1 and exit display data lines connected across port 2. So this logic I'm applying for exit part, and this logic I'm applying for entry part. So the simple logic here, one hexadecimal value you need to divide into two digits, and based on that you can follow this index. So let's see this segment of V4. Suppose V4 is 1, then it allows to read the value from this segment array as F9, so that you will get one display on 7 segment. If V3 value remains 0, then it allows to read 0 index element from this segment array. If it is keep on incrementing value 01, 02, 03, 04, then index will increment and it allows to read the specific element from this array. So now delay function is logic is very simple. I am using this self for loop concept here to generate some time delay. So if you want to see the output of this program, let's see this produce simulation tool. So this simulation tool which helps to design your hardware and link your embedded C program equivalent hex file, and you can cross check your outputs before proceeding hardware. So it's the best way. Even industries follows the same process. They never invest money on hardware directly. They will check their outputs with simulation tools and then they will approach hardware. Now I will show you the source code output here. See, the initial response is 0001. Now if I am incrementing, which means just I am changing my logic state to 1, then count will increment by 1. Let's see this count as 02. The next count is 03. So the delay is more. I'll try to reduce the delay from this program. As 01 count. Next count is 03. So try with this exit display. Now I'm making logic 1 for this exit and making logic clear. So now you will get exit count display as 01. So for each high to low state it increments one count, and the count value you can observe from this exit display. So this is how your application works. And if you keep on incrementing this for every each and each high to low pulse, you'll get one count is incremented on respective displays. This is a simple application using infrared sensors and 7 segment and microcontroller. Let's say this count is 04 and this count remains 02. So no change from this exit display. So this is your basic better practice on microcontroller based applications. So please just follow us for more videos from YouTube. Please subscribe our channel and please give your valuable feedback through comment. Please like and share. So we are doing many services on this embedded training and development services. So we are providing online and classroom trainings and personal trainings also. If you want to do any projects or if you need any technical support on this embedded C programming with all different microcontrollers, 8051, PIC, AVR, ARM, STM32, Arduino, there are many microcontrollers you are working. For any technical assistance, please get back with this number or WhatsApp with this contact number 9676327118. And we are located at Housing Board near Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad. So please write us any reviews or any requirements through this email ysnanda@eretechsolutions.com. So thanks for watching.